Good morning, legends. It's about 7:01. We're supposed to meet Paul. We're supposed to roll out at 7 o'clock from each of our houses and meet on the road. Go pick up the group. Want you to take a look at my kit. I'm going in black and white today. Hope you can get the whole view. I got the camera on my helmet. That's what I'm using. And I'm wearing my black and white kit. I'm wearing my Peugeot kit with my Rafa base layer. It's going to be, right now it's 63, which is like 17C. During the route, it'll be from 17 to 23. By the time we're done, it'll be like 73 degrees, something like that. So, I'm putting on my black mitts. I think it works best with this outfit. And I'm taking the orange bike again today. And I'm taking my food. Really didn't have any appetite this morning, so I just drank a little bit of Gatorade, not even a whole bottle. I put some in my bottle and just drank the rest. I roll out and start eating this. I'm just gonna sit in today and watch the moves. Hope you guys have as much fun as I do.
Rolling out. Cloudy day. It's very nice actually. It's gonna warm up quickly, so I don't have any arm warmers or anything on today. I got my trusty old front light on because it's overcast. There's a bit of drizzle in the air. There's a lot of moisture in the air, so it feels colder than last week, even though the temperatures are close. But I'm dressed just right. I feel good. I feel comfortable. I can't get rid of this cough. Keep sticking around. Come on, let's go. We keep sticking around. It's at the stage where it should go. Morning, guys. Morning.
I met Paul and we were to meet the bands this morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Good. The bike barn was huge this morning, man.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, we had a small group
about it. He didn't get it.
I didn't get it.
Really? Yeah, I've been telling him for weeks he didn't get it, so no problem.
We're talking
The list I'm on is only 10 people. He's got multiple lists.
Yeah. We're talking about notifications for this ride. The time change all the time. Not everybody's getting the notification. I'm sure that's
Mustard man.
What's up?
How you doing?
All right, how you doing?
I'm doing
good.
Surprisingly, feeling pretty good for not having ridden much for the whole week. So I'm ready to get back on my regular schedule.
Let's go.
This light doesn't change.
Car up!
Construction, so he's not picking up. But we'll soon be finished with that intersection. It's Mustard Man from the UK. My coach, the wind is out here. Swell, we're gonna pick up more riders. So it gets a little interesting. Tiffany teaches Zumba, so she doesn't do a lot of riding. She just comes out every now and then. So she hangs on. That's Kurt right here. I was talking about last week. And he's trying to get back in shape. His training, he's behind his training.
Gracias!
She's not thanked her in Spanish. She's not a Spanish speaker. I like to do that. I like to speak Spanish to Americans. to the Caucasian Americans. The non-hyphenated Americans. Out here, the pace is picking up. We're turning here. This is where we're getting out on the open road, and I'm making sure everybody kind of stays together. Corey's up there. He's keeping an eye out for Tiffany because he knows that she's struggling with this pace. You know, she doesn't ride that frequently. She's in shape, but that's from a different sport. She's a runner. All the fitness doesn't transfer over because the muscles are used to it.
That's okay. You stay there. I'll drift back.
So I know he wants to go fast today, so I just told him, go ahead and go out. I'll stay with her. Because he wants to hit him on the board. So I decided I would just drift back and pace them up gradually. Because they're having trouble over in the turns. Going up that hill, that was hard. So I'm just keeping the effort. Right now we're in zone 3. And on my wheel, I'm checking. You'll note that I'm constantly, you hear the wind when I turn my head. I want to make sure. I'm looking down to make sure. So Mustard is behind me. Chartreuse jersey that is behind on his training, and then Tiffany is there. I just look back to see. I'm making sure they're on my wheel. I'm not trying to pull them up to these guys yet because it would cause them to drop. Back up pretty easily, but I had to let him go again because I had to slow down for the people I'm pulling. Mustard's there, she's on Mustard's wheel, and Kurt is back there. He's trying to keep it steady for them. And the funny thing about it, you're gonna see in a little bit, is talk about people that ride don't really understand how everything works, like how group dynamics work. Because there's a guy in here, I was talking about Kurt, you're gonna see what he does even after I gave him clear suggestions on what to do that I know works. And I'm staying back here by choice. Those guys are right there. And he doesn't even understand that. I'm not sure what he's thinking, but obviously he's unaware, you know, cybernetic systems. He's not. So I basically come back here and I watch. I'm on that, and I'm gonna look for them, and they're not there. So I gradually pulled back, and it just basically, I rode them off my wheel without really trying. I wasn't going that hard. In zone 3, the back there, so I'm waiting to give them a little bit, you know, because if I go up to those guys, they're gonna be riding along. And I told Corey I would hang out and wait for Tiffany. So I turn, look back again, and I'm still waiting. They're coming. So now I'm gonna let you guys watch and listen to this exchange. Develops.
Save your energy. Just sit on my wheel. Come on, Kurt, in the draft.
That's Kurt on the left of the yellow line. You heard what I said. Watch what he does. And this is what you don't do, boys and girls. If you're struggling, find a wheel. Who could not hold the pace. There is no way he's going to catch those guys. No way. Not going to happen. If you can't stay on the wheels, you're not going to be able to catch them. And that's anybody. If you can't follow somebody in the draft, you're not catching them. So watch. They're slowing down for these turns. So he's getting all excited. He's killing himself. Watch. He's not sipping the gas. Watch. He's taking everything in the tank just to get to them. Watch what happens.
Just sit on my wheel, Tiffany.
So I decided to just tell Tiffany to stay on my wheel because she's a cyclist. She knows how this stuff works. These guys are clueless. They just ride. So Tiffany knows what she's doing. She said, "Girl," I said, "Okay." And I decided to pull. Now watch my speed. 22 heart rate. It's gonna go up as we're going into the east wind. But I'm gonna keep it steady. Now watch. Kurt is still up there on his own. He caught up to those guys in that corner, and they rode away from him. He's done. He's cooked, toasted, fried, whatever you want to call it. Because he doesn't know what he's doing. You can't stay on somebody's wheel. You're not going to catch them. Not going to happen. You're not going to make up 10, 15 seconds on somebody who you can't even sit in the draft on. So you can see the guys are pulling away from him. There's a group of guys up there, and he's in no man's land yet again. So I'm just going same speed, trying to keep it steady for Tiffany. once she gets in a rhythm, you can go faster. Give people a chance to get up to speed. Kurt's riding him over his head. He's not in condition to be trying to do what he's trying to do. And he's going about, I'm letting this car know we're going straight here. He was going to turn. So, you'll watch my heart rate keeps going up, even though the speed is the same, but because of the wind. I edited this pole. This was a long pole. Those guys they're about 10 to 15 seconds up the road. And I think I see a rider up there. Cars here. Yeah, right. Somebody on the right there. They're not that far ahead. There's a couple of guys that made this light, and so they went ahead. And the rest of these guys are stopped at the light. And Tiffany's on my wheel because she knows how to ride.
They didn't even have 15 seconds on us, so don't worry about it.
Yeah, she's getting a little warm, so she's taking off her gilet. Because it's a warm morning. It's about 60, but it's muggy.
Because we have a lot of... I can be stronger today. I'm
put your stuff up.
I'll just carry it for right now.
You stuck it in your jersey. Okay.
Thank you.
Good, let's go. Come on.
Yeah, I didn't want her holding that on her bars since she's having trouble hanging on to the fast
that happens.
Pace.
The body's really strained.
Well, they all go to the gas station.
Yeah, they're not that far ahead, really.
It's a long pole here. I edited it. This is a long stretch we're going on.
Yeah.
And she and I just rode in to get our bits of the pole. At this point, we're just talking.
Yeah, Corey's pretty fast.
We're talking about
last week when Corey was on the time trial bike. After he took that long pull, nobody wanted to pull. Everybody was tired. I just kind of laughed.
That's when I went way off the back. But luckily someone was with me. I was like, well.
You know.
I was like, at least I know my way around the woodlands.
Well, the thing is as a group, it's okay if they're split. But there should be people looking out for the last split so that we know everybody's okay. You know, that's why it's okay for the group to split up. You can have A, B, C, D, whatever. But make sure the last person has a partner or something. It's not a big deal.
Yeah, it's not a
race.
So
when he looked back, I told him, I said, I'll hang back. That's why he went. I knew he wanted to ride faster.
Well, because he was looking back at me.
Yeah, I told him, I said, go, I'll hang back.
I get lots of chances to ride fast.
I get to go fast most of the year, so... These rides, like last week, Corey pulled us to catch the break after I had pulled up the hill. Because he's smart. He sat in the draft. I pulled up two hills. So he got the rest. Then after the hill, he brought his time trial. We slices the wind. I got on his wheel. He's pulling us at 31 miles an hour.
Gas station closed?
I guess. You smell the fumes?
Yeah.
Yeah, something leaked.
This is our stop.
Yeah, I can smell the fumes. I can smell the fumes.
Gas fumes. Something's going on. So we had to
go
to another gas
store. Well, we had it.
Convenience store about maybe a half block
away. I'll catch you guys up here.
Station. I didn't film that. We basically took this road.
There's some leak over there. That's a leak. That's fine. Yeah, well, that thing blocks the wind, and this is a very warm morning. So yeah,
she's talking about her gilet. So after the stop at the Shell station, we're back on course. Boys were chatting around, decided to get to the front and kind of lighten up the pace a little bit.
Yeah, Steve has a nephew.
Over here, I took a long pull. I don't know if I edited it or sped it up. I don't remember right off, but if you watch, I am just at the base of Zone 4. This thing says 1%. Yeah, it's probably 1.7. It stays like this for most of the ride. This is a grade. And we have the wind. You can can see my heart rate keeps going up, the speed city, I sped it up. I want you to look at the speed and look at my heart rate. It's gonna stay between 22 to 23 miles an hour, about 35K maybe, I'm guessing. And my heart rate keeps going up because this rim keeps going up. And with the wind, that's what happens when you climb. That's why you have to get a rhythm. If you watch my cadence, it's at least 90 to 100. I was there for about 4 minutes, I'm guessing. Almost 4 minutes. It's a long pull. And it was a hard pull. And you see my heart rate getting up 177. And the speed's going down because of the terrain. Look at the pace, 240, 245. I pulled for a long time, but I was feeling pretty good considering I hadn't ridden. But I just wanted to see. I'm sitting very low. End of my pull. Roll over, flick my elbow. Steve comes through his knees. Steve's a guy who sets up this group, UMC group that we broke up.
Come in. You got it.
So this guy let me in, and I just go in. It's better to, like what you see me do, it's better to do that because you get shelter right away. And watch my heart rate. Once I get in the draft, right now what I'm doing is just drinking. I'm not thirsty. I just want to get some water in after a hard effort. So the next time if I need to go hard again, I don't have to worry about what I'm behind on fluids. But you want to get in as soon as you can and take shelter so your heart rate can settle. I pulled at a pace that was tolerable for me. Street is like a semi-circle that is concave, I guess. Yeah, concave. So we're gonna be going left, so basically gonna go north, then go west, and then go back south on this same road. It's like a hat. Maybe it's convex.
Jacques Anquetil is next.
Tell him Paul about the next history that's coming up. Finish my research.
That boy had class, man. I'm telling you. Just class.
Paul loves the history videos. So do most of the legends on the channel. I love this one too.
The silent assassin.
Yeah. Those boys could ride, man. No power meters, no nothing.
The village of Alden Bridge.
No arrow bars.
That look like the villages I grew up in. There were no signs. No signs, no traffic light, and no pavement.
My parents grew up in
the yep.
I don't know if you guys noticed the new logo in the top right corner. My wife helped me design it. I like it better than just the Velo. The Velo was temporary. It was a placeholder I was testing. And she came up with the layout of the lettering. And it's perfect. is the local. Easy to see out of the way. Transparent.
Green, let's go.
So my IT background has been very, very useful in getting this channel up and rolling. I've been able to do a lot of developmental work on my own designs.
All right.
My own website. See here, this guy just rolled through the side. I don't do that.
I made rolling his stop signs like this.
I made eye contact with that driver.
Must have a lot of faith in these drivers. I don't.
I'd much rather work and get it back up and get hit by a car. Roll to the side. Don't do that. This group does not set the standards of cycling etiquette that I aspire to. It's not my group. We just hook up with them. They're a fast group. You know, but they do some crazy stuff sometimes. Even when you're with the group, if other people take chances, you need to look out for number one. You still have to ride like you ride when you're solo. Like you saw my hand out there, I made eye contact with that driver. I didn't care that he'd already gone through. I made sure that driver saw me. If that driver had not acknowledged me, I would have stopped.
Until I know they're stopping, I'm not going in front of no cars. Yeah. These guys are nuts.
We're just commenting on that.
Like, man, yeah. I got to make sure that driver sees me. And make sure that it's okay. It's rolling through the air like
this. Somebody one day.
Yeah, the jersey that you guys are wearing
right
here.
Too frequently.
Woods and clubs.
The odds and the probability are not in your favor.
Highly overrated.
It's not a whole lot of fun. Nah.
Yeah, Corey's saying he's been hit by a car. He's got a scar to prove.
One time is too many.
Yeah.
Been there, done that.
got
the scars
wrist.
To prove it.
That scar there. Yeah. Steel bolts in my wrist.
Yep.
So he's hit by a car.
So no. Until they acknowledge that.
It may have reset my computer too. Yeah.
It's definitely, it takes a while to get back out there comfortably. Because you get paranoid and
she didn't know me before the accident.
Yeah.
She only known.
Well, she settled you down. You were crazy then.
I don't know.
He's crazier now?
Yeah.
Touché.
Yeah.
1 point for Tiffin. Yeah, the jersey that we're in here belongs to the Woodland Cycling Club. This is the area we're riding in. That club, they stop for all the signs and everything. And if you don't, you're going to be personal on the club now. Do not condone that. These guys here are a bunch of wild cards. And they just do stuff. I mean, they're not too bad, but right there, that was a little touching a little there. I like to make sure. We were even told by our state trooper that if you act like you're stopping, fine, they're not going to bother you. They've stopped us before and gave us a lecture. So, you know, the state trooper said, yeah, we understand you guys are rolling and you got your speed up and everything, but you need to. It's state law, you know. So there are groups where the first rider will put their foot down at the stop sign. Then you all can go through as a train. That is the way to legally do it. When I ride solo, if there are cars at the intersection, I stop. If it's just me, I slow down, I check before I go through. I do not increase my chances of having accidents. So with these guys, when they're doing that stuff, I back off and behave like I do when I ride solo. That's why you saw me in third position, slow down and let the gap open. And put my hand out because I was motioning to that driver. When the driver made eye contact with me, then I went through. Because not everybody stops at the stop sign, it's not even cars. You can't assume that because it's a four-way stop, they're gonna stop. That's what that was. It wasn't a stop sign just for us. Everybody stops. They do that in this part of the area to keep the traffic calm. Slowing people down frequently. use some of these things that these guys do as a guide for etiquette. They don't set the standards. I like to ride with them because it's convenient. I pick them up close by, but they're not exactly great role models in all the way. See all the other cyclists coming the other way. This is a morning, big guys. Area for riders. A lot of people ride out here. We have a lot of triathletes out here, a lot of runners. So here we're going to turn left.
White car could have gone. I see that white car could have been gone. The cars do that. Even when I'm driving my car, they'll get to these four-way stops and act like they don't know what to do.
Yeah. You know, you're so right. I don't trust people at stop signs.
Yeah, they don't know what to do. Yeah. They don't know who's supposed to go. We get that right in our neighborhood every day.
Always think about that.
Yeah, you have to make sure. Yeah.
The stops first.
They're not sure. They don't know the rules.
Well, another thing I love about this sport, what other sport are you going to be doing where you're going relatively, reasonably hard, and you can still talk. You're having a conversation. Cycling is just cool. It's a very social sport. Yeah. So, there's another notch for our sport. So here we turn, and we're going up a grade, and it's windy. It starts.
This is a climb here. Yeah, this is a good stop,
right,
man.
Corey's talking about.
Got a bathroom and water. All the body needs.
I stop at this park on the right. We're passing frequently when I come through here, especially in the summer, to refill my bottles. Because it's right at the hour 40 mark. So when I'm doing a 3-hour ride there, about to stop there and refill in the summer. I'm going to try to have water and not need it the other way around. So they've got facilities. Just fill up and go.
When you pass this intersection, do what I'm doing. Use the shoulders.
She's struggling, so I'm trying to get her to do an echelon.
Get up there, come on.
And she's killing herself.
Don't kill yourself. Go on his right. Go on his right. There, stay right there. Don't pass him. That's where the draft is.
She's working really
hard. Stay at an angle.
Because she.
Wind's coming from the left.
Zumba. She teaches Zumba. And it's a different kind of workout. So she doesn't put to herself.
Let's stay right there.
She's fit, but her muscles aren't used to it. So we're setting up an echelon here.
It's an echelon! This is like, this is in Belgium.
And you can see we're just right off the back here. And I'm trying to just pull them through. But she's just struggling. And I'm ready to ride. You know? And Corey can sense it. So he's going to turn me loose. He's going to say, you go ahead. The group's right there. That's why I like to be fit. I mean, it's like, they're moving at a...
Hey there!
We're moving at a good pace and I'm messing around, speaking to a dog, and doing all of that. When you're in good shape, you can do all that crap. You know, when you're struggling, man, you can't really have too much fun. That's why I ride. He just told me to go. He said, go ahead. So I go ahead and just, I'm going to start shifting up. I'm going to use a big gear because I'm going to treat it like I'm climbing. I'm gonna use power and my strength to get up there. And I get up there pretty quickly. 24 into the wind. This is not a flat road, even though it says zero. None of these roads up here are flat. This Kurt back here, he looks like he's struggling. He needs a fit. His saddle's a little high. His hips are rolling. That's how you can tell. So he's not as efficient as he could be. I don't know why people always want to jack up their saddle so high.
My back!
He should not be reaching for anything. His hips are rolling, but his body's reaching at the bottom of the stroke. There should be no rolling of the hips. I think it happened over here. There's a guy riding on the wrong side of the road, and I actually flagged him.
Get in, come on.
Telling Paul to get in. I don't know how they ended up out there to win. But I think Alan pulled off, and then Paul pulled up. Paul did not want to stay at the front. He's still getting back regiment. So he's not gonna sit up there and pull to this week. I'm hoping I can ride more this week. I need at least 2 days in my legs before the weekend. And I should be fine. I should be able to
go back.
We're rolling along here. I think somewhere around here, I flagged it in the edits. There's a guy coming at us. Right there. I tagged him moron because he has to be.
Yo, that side of the road.
Idiot riding his bike on the wrong side of the road. Coming directly to us like we.
I mean, golly.
Like we're in the wrong spot. Like this is, like he's in England.
That's the stuff little kids do. That's a grown man don't know how to ride.
I mean, I don't see how people.
This is not the UK.
I'm messing with mustard. Yeah, people in the UK say we drive on the wrong side of the road in the US. That's the joke.
I think he's from the UK. And he forgot that we're driving on the wrong side of the road. He forgot that we drive on the wrong side of the road over here on this side of the pond. Yeah, I mean, come on, that's the stuff little kids do. He's coming right at us, and he's okay with that. Sheesh.
Yeah, he didn't look scared.
You get to an intersection, and nobody knows what the heck you're going to do.
Yeah, I don't know. I couldn't ride a bike like that.
It's like, man.
What do you do at an intersection?
Get those, get your cow. But he's coming right at me. Like I'm in the wrong spot. I'm like, come on, buddy. I would be a DPS officer and just stop him for the hell of it. So look, man. Yeah. Yeah, like we're on the wrong side of the road.
Yeah, he looked at us.
He's
like,
looking at us like what?
Yeah. That was fun. The look on his face, I wish the camera could have caught that. But this guy just came out of the door. Grown man. And lived that long.
Voice.
What happened to the natural thinning of the herd?
That's what the boys like to play.
Nah, I should. That's my coach. You can see I'm just sitting. I'm trying to give you guys a good shot. That's why I said this is not easy. We're going 24 into the wind. You know, so I moved up a little closer, but I'm staying to the left so the camera can get a view. If I stay directly behind the person, you can't see. So I catch a little more wind, but that's fine. It's been working out. Andy's been up there pulling. I cut his pole. I just kept, you can see now my cadence. When I start to ride, my cadence goes up. We're riding. I'm in zone 4, we're riding. So my cadence is up. Now it's on. It's time to do some work. When I'm messing around, my cadence is up. And most riders, most of the top riders, that's what they do. When it's time to take care of business, cadence goes up, whatever gear you use, that's just the way to ride, because it's just, you're more flexible, you can react to changes in speed a lot easier, you don't have to be straining and arching your back, so just keep that in mind as you ride, just try it on your next ride, shift down, see how quickly you can change your speed, and if you grind, not like it's a time trial. It's a time trial. Once you get up to cruising speed, you get to your cruising cadence, you go in a road race, you got to be able to change your speed. That's why I like that the shifters are so conveniently placed nowadays. I mean, we used to race in a bad boy down to. You can't shift much, man. You found a gear and you play with it. Rose to the front, I'm keeping my eye on it to see what's going on. happened to me was scratching my ass while I was riding. So I think it's because of inactivity this week. So I rode through these guys, I rode by those guys because they were not pedaling. I was still close. We're turning here. This is the road where the turn is a hill. They probably won't register this thing.
Up.
I've already downshifted. Just watch my cadence. When we turn the corner, I'm already at 100. I'm in triple digits because we're going up a grade into the wind. This is another grade. I cut the pole on there because it was, I don't know, for a while. But you can see I'm 110 plus. I think I got up to 120. Shoulder is wide, but when you turn, it's narrow. So you gotta make sure it's clear.
Car left. Clear after this.
Right there. See how narrow that is? Come back over. And this shoulder is nice and wide. So I gradually, I look back to make sure everybody made it through, then I gradually get the speed up. I cut this pole too, but this is a long stretch. Still pull for a few minutes. So I'm headed to this as well. I don't sit up here too long. I have been pulling for a while.
Well, I know everybody. Accident.
We see a lot of emergency lights at this intersection. It turns out there's been a collision. Nobody was hurt. So there's an ambulance and a fire truck. And you saw the vehicles on the road. The guy's the fire truck blocking the road right directly in front of this car.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
Yeah, there's a white car up there. It's a BMW. It's a black van. I tagged it in the video so you guys can see right there. It's a black
one. Brand new. We can walk our bikes if we have to.
The Range Rover turn.
Let's go. We can walk our bikes. Let's go. You can turn left here, so somebody cut off somebody. Range Rover smacked him.
Rolling through, attack the Range Rover. You guys can see as well, right there. The whole front is gone. Good thing is it didn't appear that anybody was seriously hurt. There was no urgency. The Flintridge Hills, and the boys are getting antsy. I see somebody off the front of that. I think it's Bob. So Alan starts to move up there.
Car left.
I've never worn out a pair of brakes on anybody at home. Even when I'm descending, I don't ride my brakes the whole time. I brake hard when I get to it. I let it go. I'm not sure what's going on in here. Somebody twitched and just moved over to use that shoulder. Didn't interfere with anything I was doing, so I just kept on keeping up. Here there's a split. So we've got five of us up front. It is late. It's about 3:20 in the morning. I'm trying to finish this. I've got a crazy day tomorrow. Great. That's okay. I reeled him back in. wanted to catch up to him and just see how my legs would be going. Since I hadn't really gone. They responded fairly well. So you can see I'm pretty much closer to it. What we did on Saturday, and I hope you guys enjoy as much as I did. It was fun. Keep riding, don't let anything stop you.